Hello guys, this is Bhupender Singh and you are watching our YouTube channel SME Dehradun. Today, I will tell you how you can interface the ultrasonic sensor with Blink 2.0 IoT mobile and web dashboard. So guys, to design this project, you need the following components. Node MCU over ESP32 Wi-Fi board, ultrasonic sensor HCSR04, breadboard, 4 male-to-male jumper wires. And this is the circuit diagram of interfacing ultrasonic sensor with ESP32 board. You need to connect your hardware according to this circuit. If you are using Node MCU ESP8266 board, then you can download the circuit diagram for it from the video description. Now connect the hardware. This is breadboard and this is ultrasonic sensor HCSR04. It's having 4 pins, VCC, trigger, eco, and ground. This is ESP32 Wi-Fi board. You can use Node MCU beside it if you want. Now I am placing ESP32 board to breadboard. Now place ultrasonic sensor on it. Now we take 4 male-to-male wire to connect ultrasonic sensor with ESP32 board. So connect VCC and ground pin of ultrasonic sensor to 3-volt pin and ground pin of ESP32 board. Guys, note it, if your sensor will not work properly, then connect VCC pin of ultrasonic sensor to 5-volt DC voltage pin of external power supply as shown in the circuit diagram. Connect eco pin to 32 and trig pin to 33 pin of ESP32 board. If you are using Node MCU, then connect eco pin to D7 and trig pin to D6 pin of Node MCU as per the circuit diagram. So our hardware connected perfectly. Now time to configure the Blink web dashboard. So open the web browser and open the Blink cloud website by typing blink.cloud. Here you can create your new account or login through your username and password. After logging, you can see the Blink dashboard. You can create your project template here. So click on the new template and template property gets opened. Here write your project name like distance measurement ultrasonic sensor. Below select hardware as ESP32. If you are using Node MCU, then select the ESP8266 here. Choose the connection type Wi-Fi. Add the description. Write your project description and click on Done. Once you have done it, you will see the Info tab. Here it is firmware configuration. We need to write it in our Arduino program. Now click on the metadata tab. Here you can see the information about your project that we have just created. In the data stream tab, we define the method of accessing the ESP32 board to Blink, like through virtual pin, analog pin or digital pins. So we go ahead with the virtual pins. Click on the new data stream and choose virtual pin. Virtual pin property gets opened. Write the name as distance, virtual pin as V0 and data type as integer. Change max value to 400 as ultrasonic can measure the distance up to 400 cm. Select the unit as centimeter and click on create. So we have created the virtual pin for ultrasonic sensor. Click on the event tab where you can create any notification for your events. By default, here is two events, online and offline, in which you got the notification. If you want to create more notification, then you can create by clicking on add new event. Now go to the web dashboard. Here we drag and drop the widgets for our virtual pins. So we drag and drop label widget in the dashboard. Now drag and drop gauze widget in the dashboard. Hover the mouse cursor on the label and you will see the setting icon on it. Click on it. Property gets opened. Select the data stream as distance V0 and click on the save button. Now open the setting of gauze widget. Select the data stream as distance V0. You can also change the color of your widget from here. We select the orange color and click on save. So this is how we can add widgets to Blink web dashboard. In the mobile dashboard tab, in which you can get the link to download the Blink IoT mobile app for your iOS and Android mobile. Now click on Save button to save the changes in your project template. Let's go for programming code. So go to the video description and click on the link given to download the program for ESP32 board as shown here. If you are using NodeMCU ESP8266 Wi-Fi board, then you can download the programming code for it from the available link in the video description. And once downloading is done, you will get the WinRAR file with the name Distance Measurement SR04. Right click on it and click on Extract here. If you don't have WinRAR or WinZip software to unzip it, then a link is available in the video description to download these softwares. Once it's unzipped, you will get the folder with the same name. Go inside the folder and open the program. In the top of the program, you can see the template ID and device name. You need to change these blank credentials with your blank credentials. So go to your blank cloud dashboard. In the info tab, you will see the firmware configuration. Copy these credentials and replace it here. And we also need to add a library of blank to our Arduino IDE. So we go to the sketch tab. Here we select the include library and click on the manage library. Your computer must be connected to the internet for it. It will download the list of all available library for the Arduino. So here we search for blank. As you can see, we got the blank library in the top. You got the install button here. Once you click on the install button, it will automatically add it to your Arduino IDE. I have already installed the blank library. Now back to the programming code. We define the blank firmware version for ESP32 board. After it, we define blank serial to print the serial data so that when it is ready, it will display in the serial monitor. After it, we define blank agent header file. We define the echo pin variable to 32 and trig pin variable to 33 because we connect the echo pin to 32 and trigger pin of ultrasonic sensor to 33 number pin of ESP32 board, right? We take duration as a long variable to store the time duration of echo received by ultrasonic sensor and distance as an integer variable to store the distance calculated through the ultrasonic sensor. Below, we create an ultrasonic function in which we calculate and measure the distance in centimeter. First, we put the trigger pin low by using digital write command. After the delay of 2 microseconds, we high the trigger pin. And after the delay of 10 microseconds, we again low the trigger pin. What is the mean of it? In order to generate the ultrasound, we need to set the trigger pin on a high state for 10 microseconds. That will send out an 8 cycle sonic burst which will travel the speed sound and it will be received in the echo pin. The echo pin will output the time in microseconds the sound wave traveled. Understand? So we read the high pulse and store that to travel time in the duration variable by using pulse in command. So we read the high pulse and store that travel time in the duration variable by using pulse in command. But what you will get from the echo pin here? We will get the double that number because the sound wave needs to travel forward and bounce backward. So in order to get the distance in centimeter, we need to multiply the received travel time value from the echo pin by 0.034 and divide it by 2. It is simple. We got the distance of the obstacle in centimeter. Now we will send that distance to the blank virtual pin by using blank dot virtual write command. So come to the setup mode. We serially begin the ESP32 board at 9600 baud rate. We are not using 34 number pin of ESP32, so ignore this command. Now we define the trig pin as output and echo pin as an input. Now we begin the blank agent function so that it can verify and connect ESP32 board to the blank server. Now in the loop function, we call the blank agent.run function that will handle all the query called by the blank dashboard. And below, we call the ultrasonic function so that it will measure the distance through it. So our programming code has been finished. Time to upload the program to ESP32 board. Connect the ESP32 board to the computer's USB port. Now select the Wi-Fi board. For that, you need to go to the tools and click on the board. And scroll below and select the ESP32 Grover board. If you don't know how to install the ESP32 or a NodeMCU board to the Arduino IDE, then a link is available in the video description that will show you how you can install it to the Arduino IDE. After selecting the board, you need to select the COM port. So go to the port and select the port as COM at, as I do. Now click on the upload button to upload the program to the board. As you can see, uploading process is going on and it's done. So now let's download the Blink mobile app so that we can connect our ESP32 board to Wi-Fi. So go to the App Store and search for Blink. And Android user, they can download it from the Play Store. As you can see, we have got the legacy Blink app. That is an old version. Scroll below and you will see the Blink IoT new app. You need to install this app. Once downloaded, open the Blink app. Here we got the two options, sign up or login. As we have already created an account with Blink, so login to it. Dashboard has been opened. Guys, you need to remember one more thing. In this process, your smartphone data must be on. And you cannot connect your ESP32 board or NodeMCU board to your mobile hotspot. You need to provide external Wi-Fi to connect with it. Okay? So now, click on Add New Device. As you can see, we have got three options. Connect to Wi-Fi, Scan QR Code, and Quick Start Device. Click on Connect to Wi-Fi option. In the next screen, we got the ready button. This time, provide power to your ESP32 board, and if you are using NodeMCU, then power it up. You can also connect ESP32 board to your computer's USB port for it. After it, click on ready. Guys, as you can see, we have got a pop-up that starts with Blink. If you don't find any Blink pop-up here, then you need to go to your smartphone's Wi-Fi setting and search for new Wi-Fi here. Definitely, you will find your ESP32 board or NodeMCU board that start with Blink. Select it and back to the Blink mobile app and click on ready. You will get the pop-up. Click on the join. It's configuring ESP32 board. Now it is asking to connect it with external Wi-Fi. Choose your Wi-Fi in which you want to connect. Provide the Wi-Fi credentials and click on continue. Wait for 5 to 10 seconds to configure. You do not need to do it every time. Once it connected to your Wi-Fi, then it store Wi-Fi credentials and token to the EEPROM of your Wi-Fi board. Once the profile is created, then click on continue, then done. Now exit from the app. Back to the main dashboard of the Blink. Now add the widgets to the dashboard. So click on your template and click on the setting icon. Inside it, click on the plus icon. Widgets have been appeared. Scroll below and click on the value display button. It's added to the dashboard. Now add Gauss and Superchart to the dashboard. We arrange them according to our requirement. Now we click on the value display button. Value display property has been opened. In the property, we align the title to the center. Click on the select data stream tab and select the distance V0. Increase the font size to the large and back to the dashboard. Now click on the Gauss. In the property, we align the title to the center. Click on the select data stream tab and select the distance V0. Increase the font size to large and change the Gauss color to the red and back to the dashboard. Now click on the super chart in the property, align the title to the center. Now click on the data stream setting and inside it click on the select data stream tab and select the distance V0. We also change the color to blue and back to the dashboard. So this is how our dashboard looks like. Now let's see the live testing of it. As you can see, the live distance of the sunboard from the ultrasonic sensor in the web dashboard and mobile app. As I am moving the sunboard towards the ultrasonic sensor, it is displaying the decrement of distance. It will display the exact value in the mobile app also. So guys, this is how you can interface the ultrasonic sensor with ESP32 and NodeMCU board with Blink 2.0. If you have any query or suggestion, write it in the comment box below. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel and videos. And don't forget to click on the bell icon to get the latest updates of our videos.